So welcome back to another episode, and welcome to my games room. Not this one here, but my games room from 2001, 20 years ago. And what got me thinking about this is that I've been doing a lot of videos about games that came out 20 years ago and their significance in video game history and their significance for me being a fan being back then. And today, what I thought I'd do is look at my old games room from 20 years ago, and it's going to be super nostalgic. I have showed it in a video. There was a video I did years ago called, you know, old videos from the year to like 2000 and all of that. So I thought that I'd show this today and kind of go in depth into the games room and what was kind of going on and a bit of that nostalgia, right? A lot of that nostalgia for that gaming time when the GameCube was out, the PS2 was out, that fun time. So yeah, I gotta say something to begin with. This was a crappy old apartment that I rented 20 years ago, and it wasn't the greatest thing, but it was great for me because I got to be on my own, play video games, watch anime, and eat noodles and all my good stuff that I did back then. I love that place. I have so many memories of me and Rob and my friend Satan staying up to like 7 in the morning, drinking all night, playing video games. There's a lot of memories here, that's for sure. So let's go into this games room here and have a look. The first thing that you see was something I was so proud of, and that was my Sony Vega 36-inch TV with S-Video. And the S-Video was incredible for the Dreamcast and for the GameCube, hooking it up that way, and also for the PS2 at the time. And I had a Laserdisc player that also was S-Video. It was really cool stuff. So that was the thing I was most proud of. I spent a lot of money on that TV at the time, and it was the best standard definition TV you could get at that time. And it's funny, you probably can't see in the picture, but I was mentioning under the TV there, there's a DVD player and a Laserdisc player and an amp for those old speakers, which I still have to this day. I still listen to my music on there, which is really, really funny. And we go down a little bit and look at that. This is the nostalgic bit for me as I'm looking at the picture. The GameCube is there with Pikmin as a launch game. Then I think I took this picture that very day it came out, which is really, really awesome. And so we're dealing with the GameCube launch at that point. And you go over to the left a little bit and you look under that little thing there and there's a Dreamcast. Goddamn Dreamcast was still alive and kicking at that point. I was playing Phantasy Star Online all year. And if you see there, that's the Dreamcast keyboard that I would play on, and I would type on that thing, and hooked up to 56K modem, which is really funny to think about now, isn't it? And here we go, here's some more nostalgia. The Dreamcast controller is sitting on a strategy guide for Final Fantasy X, because that had just come out as well, and that's really cool. If you go up a little bit to the table there, you can see all my VMUs, and that was for my Phantasy Star characters were all on there. That was my addiction, and I had other VMUs kicking around as well. And we go over to the right a little bit, and there is my PS2 in there kicking it. And underneath, those are all Laserdiscs. Laserdiscs were a big thing still back then, and they were a great way to collect movies, and I loved having them. And I'm still a fan of Laserdisc. I don't personally watch Laserdisc anymore, but they're there, and that's a funny bit to see. We go up a little bit, and on top of that, we got a VHS player. We still have a VHS, because I had a huge anime collection on VHS, and VHS was still... That's still the way you were getting some animes back then. It's kind of hard to believe we're breaking away from that. We're getting into the DVD era, but this is kind of funny. And look at that, on top of there, if you got good eyes here, there's the VV from the VV Christmas tree. I got him all the way back then. And there's some DVDs on there and stuff like that. And isn't that cool? If you kind of go up a little bit, there's my Cowboy Bebop wall scroll that I had. Now, Willem Chow got me a new one, but I had that back in the day, and I was just getting into Bebop back then. Bebop was a huge big deal for me, and I was buying the DVDs, and the DVDs were really expensive. You'd spend like $40 on a DVD, and I think you'd get 2 or 3 episodes if you're lucky. That's the way it was before downloading and stuff like that and streaming services, so that's how you got things back then. And if you go over, we got a little bit of a Totoro going on over there. And there is my Resident Evil 3 standee from back then. And you know what's so funny? That was only a couple of years old, because Resident Evil 3 came out in 1999, and we're in the year 2001 here at this point. So really nostalgic to see this games room. And this is just where I would sit every day and play video games. I would always sit on the floor and play games. I've always kind of done that. It's kind of a funny thing. So that's the main game room right there. Okay, we're gonna go to the rest of the games. Now, I gotta say, most of the games were in the closet. That's how I stored games back then. That's how I did it. I only had so much room in this apartment to be able to display stuff. But I did take a photo of some of the stuff I enjoyed displaying, and that's what I'm gonna show right now. We'll start at the bottom. You can see my TurboGrafx is there, and also the N64, the Sega Master System, and a couple of Nintendos. I had a couple of Nintendos back then. And we got a 3DO in there. We got my Neo Geos going on, the Nomad, which has been here for forever. And above that is my Neo Geo collection at that time. Oh man, I've always loved the Neo Geo. It's one of the things I wish I could have collected for, because it's one of the systems I really, truly love. And isn't it funny, on top of the Neo Geo games, there's my Earthbound, my original Earthbound. And I think to the right of that, in the purple, that's Far East of Eden Zero, if I'm correct. And to the left there is an assortment of, it looks like Sega Genesis and Super Nintendo games, my games. And look at that, and even above we got, you know, Zelda. All the games that I have right here are on the shelf there, and Popful Mail's going on there as well, and some Sega Master System games. These were the games I was displaying, the games that I absolutely loved, and the games I still love to this day. My TurboGrafx collection is on there as well, and we've got some NES games, we've got my Dragon Warrior games, and you know what's really interesting is Dragon Warrior 2 was one of the very first games I bought off eBay, because I had just the cartridge and I always wanted the box, because I had the box for all the rest. And I remember being so scared. And I remember spending, I think, $80 on it. And I thought, oh my God, that's so expensive. And it was not that expensive when you think about it now. But back in, we're talking 20 years ago, I spent that. Because I wanted to have Dragon Warrior 1, 2, 3, and 4 in box. And I was able to finally get that. And then we get into some PS1 games and some Dreamcast games going on right there. But yeah, that's how I kind of displayed my games, and it's really kind of fun to see how they were kind of stacked up. As I say, I had a lot of other games and stuff like that, but they were in the closet. Now, this next photo was from my bedroom at the time, and I got a small tear when I saw this, because I saw the poster there for Ease is there right to begin with all the girls from Ease. I love seeing that. I was like, oh my God, is that ever a product of a different time? And these were all my CDs. These were all my like video game and anime soundtracks all stacked up on there. And underneath there, this is fun too, those are all my cassettes. Yes, the cassettes now are in a tote in the closet, but I still listen to cassettes back then. Some songs I only had on cassettes. And again, I can't tell you, we weren't living in the YouTube world we're living in now, so you held on to your media because maybe that was the only way you could ever hear that song again. That's how you felt. Streaming media was not what it was and is now. So holding on to physical media was a really, really big deal from this era and from this time period. And I'm still very nostalgic to have all these items, you know, like anime soundtracks on cassette. It's such a crazy novelty thing. And then we go underneath there and we have all my art books and stuff like that, which I still have in the other room, and all my anime art books and stuff. So yeah, it was really cool to like, cause I'd be late in bed and I'll have all my stuff, so I could just go get music or I could go and get books, and it was really cool. Okay, this picture really made me laugh. This is just ridiculous here. This is just ridiculous. This is kind of like my media, all my movies and anime and all that, and it's just kind of like, boom, here you go. And you can see a Super Nintendo right there at the bottom, but we got all my VHS tapes of anime, and I had a lot. And that's how I got it. That's how I saw Macross Plus for the first time. That's how I saw Street Fighter, the animated movie, for the first time. You traded tapes with each other. That's what you did. So that came with me. That was like, I'm having all of this. And so I had all of that. And do you know, even on that Sony Vega, I was still watching anime on VHS. I was still watching that kind of stuff on that TV. And it looked really good, and that TV was great for the best standard definition TV ever, I swear to God. But it would take VHS and it would make it look pretty good, the best it could look at the time. And then we get into the kind of the middle here, and we have some anime tapes that I bought, and just some movies, physical movies I actually bought, not, you know, tape from a tape or something like that, physical copies. And it's kind of neat, you can see Madox in there, Nadia, The Secret of Blue Water, Macross Plus I bought, and Ixtra 1 I even have on VHS here, which is just ridiculous. And some live action movies like Terminator and Blade Runner, stuff I really like. And I just gotta say, VHS tapes of animes back then ridiculously expensive. You go buy one tape, I swear, and it'd have one or two episodes, it'd be $40. That's what I was even saying for the Cowboy Bebop and DVD. Things were really expensive. Anime was an expensive hobby to get into and maintain because you had to buy physical copies, and it was expensive. A lot of my money back then went into buying anime DVDs. Oh my God, there was so much. But if you look up to the left there, you can see all my Macross Plus on DVD and all the Cowboy Bebops on DVD and all the Evangelions and all Triguns and Gasarakis and Nadiscos in there as well. So yeah, a lot of fun time. And you know, all my friends would come over to my place and we'd all watch anime over here because I had it all over here. But man, I gotta say, I had so many fun times in that apartment. It wasn't the greatest apartment. It definitely wasn't. But it was my apartment. And I think back to playing Shenmue there and Phantasy Star there and hanging out with my friends there. And, you know, it was our spot. It was our place and all of that. And I remember playing Phantasy Star and turning up the music a little bit and my neighbors knocking on the ceiling. They were just banging on it. And it was so funny back then because it was like a wooden building. So if you turned up a little bit of music, you could hear it. And I mean, it was even 8 o'clock at night. It wasn't that loud, but yeah, knowing me, it probably was that loud. But a lot of memories. I just wanted to show you my games room from back all those years ago, 20 years ago. I wanted to do it on the anniversary of this month. It made so much sense. So anyways, guys, until next time.